Hello friends, welcome to a new episode of Drishti IAS Editorial Analysis. In this editorial analysis, we do three things. First of all, we link the editorial to the UPSC syllabus. Secondly, we try to understand the key points of the editorial. And thirdly, if any key concepts have come in the editorial and are important from exam point of view, we also discuss them. So let us begin today's editorial analysis.
Dear viewer, this video is available in Hindi as well. If you wish to watch it, please visit our Hindi YouTube channel, Drishti IAS. For your convenience, the link for this video in Hindi has been provided in the description below.
We have taken today's editorial from the Hindu and it has come on 23rd of July. The title of the editorial is Another Front. It says that India and Bhutan must have complete understanding on dealing with China's claims. So let us look at its linkage with the syllabus. So we find that it links directly with GS paper 2, where we have international relations as one of the important topics. Under this, it links with India and its neighborhood relations, because here Bhutan-China relations are important from India's relations with both Bhutan and with China. So after establishing the linkage with the syllabus, now let us look at the key points of the editorial. So before moving on to the key points of the editorial, let us understand what the issue is all about. So here in this map, we can see Bhutan and the Sakteng Wildlife Sanctuary located in eastern Bhutan. So in June 2020, in a meeting of the Global Environment Facility, which is jointly managed by UNDP, World Bank and United Nations Environment Programme, their Chinese representative objected to the claiming that Sakteng Wildlife Sanctuary comes in a disputed portion between Bhutan and China. Now this Sakteng Wildlife Sanctuary had received funding from Global Environment Facility earlier as well, and China had never objected till that point. And as we can see in the map, that Bhutan is acting as a buffer state between China and India. Also in 2017, there was controversy between China, Bhutan and India over Doklam region. So the Doklam Plateau is located somewhere here in the trijunction between China, India and Bhutan. Now let us look at Bhutan more closely in another map. So in this map we can see the location of Doklam Plateau, and there is also a pass called Dokala. Here we have the Chumbi Valley, which is shaped in the form of a dagger, and it is very close to the Siliguri corridor, which is very critical from India's security perspective. And China wants to get a toehold here so that it can cut off the Siliguri corridor whenever tensions between India and China rise, or if there is a military confrontation between the two countries. And that is why India is very sensitive to Chinese presence in the Doklam Plateau. Now, border talks between Bhutan and China had been going on for a long time, and there have been 24 rounds of talks. And the talks were concentrated on this area shown in yellow and this area. There was never this mention of the eastern portion of Bhutan, which now China is claiming. And here we can see that China shares no border with this portion of Bhutan, but because it claims Tawang as South Tibet, it is claiming this portion of Bhutan as well. And China had earlier offered Bhutan a package deal whereby it had said that you give us this area and in return you take this area, which is more in terms of land area, because China wants to get toehold in this area, especially near to Siliguri corridor. And in this map of Bhutan, we can very clearly see that which are the areas which are disputed between China and Bhutan. So this is the Doklam Plateau, and it is about 269 square kilometer, which is disputed. And the northern Bhutan area, which is Jakarlung and Pasamlung Valley. So these are totaling around 495 square kilometers. And China had offered a package deal to Bhutan that you give us this area and in return you take over this area. But now China has opened another front by claiming this Trasigang area of Bhutan, which is in the eastern sector and which is adjoining Tawang area of Arunachal Pradesh. Now here we need to know that Bhutan and China have no formal diplomatic relations, There have been 24 rounds of boundary talks between the two countries between 1984 and 2016. And the talks have focused on North and West Bhutan regions only. And specifically, three areas have been discussed in these talks: the Jakarlung and Pasamlung areas in the north, and Chumbi Valley, where Doklam is situated in the west. Eastern Bhutan has never been part of these boundary talks so far. But in June 2020, China has attempted to stop UNDP Global Environment Facility funding for Saktang Wildlife Sanctuary by claiming it was in the disputed area between Bhutan and China. But this was overruled by the funding agency and funding has been approved. So after having this background, let us see the key points of the editorial. So the editorial starts by saying that for the third time since early July, China has repeated its claim that Bhutan's eastern boundary was a disputed area. And the very first claim by China was at UNDP-led Global Environment Facility Conference on June 2 and 3, when the Chinese representative tried to stop funding for the Saktang Forest Reserve, which is located in Bhutan's eastern district of Trasigang, which adjoins Tawang district of Arunachal Pradesh. And this claim was surprising for several reasons. First of all, China has never objected earlier to funding provided to this sanctuary at the Global Environment Facility, as this wildlife sanctuary has received funding from GEF earlier as well. Secondly, the Trasigang area does not share a boundary with China. So how does a boundary dispute arise? Thirdly, Chinese officials have not raised this eastern boundary in the 24 rounds of talks with Bhutan that began in 1984. And so far the border talks had revolved around the northern Bhutan territories of Pasamlung and Jakarlung valleys and Doklam and other pasture lands to the western side of Bhutan. But on 22nd of July, China has again referred to a package solution for the dispute that is believed to refer to an offer which was made in 1990s to swap the northern and western areas, which Bhutan had rejected given India's concern. And here we must note that India and Bhutan have enjoyed very good relations. In fact, there is very special relationship between India and Bhutan. Now Bhutan has responded by rejecting the Chinese claims at Global Environment Facility, and it was also able to secure funding for the wildlife sanctuary. Subsequently, the Bhutanese embassy in Delhi has also served a demarche to the Chinese embassy. And here we must note that Bhutan does not enjoy diplomatic relations with China, and the countries are not having each other's embassy. That is why the Bhutanese embassy in Delhi has served this demarche to China. And here we should also know what is a demarche. So demarche is a formal diplomatic representation of one government's official position, views or wishes on a given subject to an appropriate official in another government. So it's a formal diplomatic communication. And now Bhutan has also stated that it is ready to discuss all the disputes in the next round of China-Bhutan talks. The last round of talks was in 2016 and they had been put off in 2017 due to the Doklam standoff and due to elections in 2018 and due to pandemic this year. The editorial says that both Bhutan and India have not reacted to the Chinese claims in a rash manner, and both countries have responded in a very guarded manner. And the editorial says that for Bhutan, the Chinese claim can be seen as a pressure tactic, most likely an attempt to hurry the scheduling of the next meeting for discussing the border, or to gain some leverage in the boundary talks by claiming additional area. The editorial says that for India, which is already dealing with Chinese aggression across the line of actual control, especially in the Ladakh sector, the Saktang claim could be a diversionary tactic or one aimed at driving a wedge between India and Bhutan, because China realizes that India and Bhutan share very special relationship, and China has been trying to create rifts between India and its neighbors, be it Nepal, be it Bangladesh. With almost all the countries with which India is having good relations in the neighborhood, China is trying to get into the picture and disturb the relations. Also, by claiming Bhutan's eastern boundary, China is maybe trying to bolster its claim over Arunachal Pradesh, especially the Tawang region, which it claims to be the South Tibet. Also, the repetition of the package offer implies that China is not giving up its push for the Doklam Plateau, where it has consolidated its military infrastructure and would like to inch towards India's Siliguri corridor, which is very strategically sensitive for India. Finally, the editorial says that whatever may be the Chinese designs, both India and Bhutan must realize that they should not allow China to get in between their good relationship over so many years, and they should deal with the Chinese threat unitedly, which will create pressure on China, whereas China would like to deal with Bhutan separately so that it can have its way with Bhutan. So this was all in the key points of the editorial. Now let us look at some key concepts. So in key concepts, let us look at India-Bhutan relations. So India and Bhutan share a traditionally warm and friendly relationship, which is relatively trouble-free when compared to other South Asian countries. The basic framework of India-Bhutan bilateral relations has been the Treaty of Friendship and Cooperation, which was signed in 1949 between the two countries. Bhutan had become a British protectorate in 1910. Now, the diplomatic relations between India and Bhutan were established in 1968 with the establishment of Special Office of India in Thimphu, which is Bhutan's capital. Another important thing to note here is that India and Bhutan share a 699-kilometer border. Also, Guru Padmasambhava, a Buddhist saint, also played an influential role in spreading Buddhism and deepening the traditional ties between people in both Bhutan and India. And Bhutan is also central to India's two major foreign policies, which is Neighbourhood First Policy and Act East Policy. We should also note that Bhutan shares borders with four Indian states: Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, West Bengal and Sikkim. Bhutan serves as a buffer between India and China, but unlike Nepal, Bhutan has never played the China card against India. And Bhutan has repeatedly turned down Chinese package deal, which offered it bigger territorial concessions in return for the smaller Doklam area. And this was done by Bhutan because Bhutan is sensitive to India's security concerns in the area, especially with respect to the Siliguri corridor. And Bhutan and India are also part of other multilateral forums such as BBIN and BIMSTEC. A politically stable Bhutan is important to India, as unstable situations in Bhutan can provide a safe haven to anti-India activities and anti-India militant groups. And Bhutan played a very effective role in flushing out Alpha rebels, which helped in curtailing insurgency in Northeast. Now let us look at Global Environment Facility. It was established in October 1991, and the aim is to provide new and additional grants and concessional funding to cover additional costs associated with transforming a project with national benefits into one with global environmental benefits. Membership is 180 member governments in partnership with international institutions, NGOs and private sector. And it is also the largest funder of projects to improve the global environment, and it provides grants for projects related to biodiversity, climate change, land degradation, ozone depletion and persistent organic pollutants and international waters. Also, another important thing to note here is that Global Environment Facility acts as a financial mechanism for five major international environmental conventions. One is the Minamata Convention on Mercury. Second, Stockholm Convention on Persistent Organic Pollutants. Third is United Nations Convention on Biological Diversity. Fourth is United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, UNCCD, and United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCCC. And Global Environment Facility is jointly managed by UNDP, World Bank, and United Nations Environment Program. This is also important to note. Plus, its headquarters is at Washington, D.C. So this was all in today's editorial analysis. Let us see what kind of questions can be asked in prelims and mains. So in prelims, one can be asked about location-based questions. So one should be clear about the location of Bhutan, Chumbi Valley, Doklam Plateau, Sakteng Wildlife Sanctuary, which has been in news, and which is in the eastern part of Bhutan. also the location of Tawang in Arunachal Pradesh, and the location of Siliguri Corridor, and the chicken snack portion of the Siliguri Corridor, which is only 17 km wide. And this is very important from India's security point of view. Also, we should be knowing about the border length that India shares with Bhutan, which is around 699 km. And also, question can be asked on Global Environment Facility, about UNDP, UNEP, and the World Bank, which are jointly managing this Global Environment Facility, and when was it established. So, such kind of questions can be asked in prelims. In mains, the question can be on India-Bhutan relations. What are the advantages in India-Bhutan relations, both for India and for Bhutan? And also, the question can be towards the China factor in India-Bhutan relations. Another question can be on the China-Bhutan boundary talks and how it has security implications for India. So these are the kind of questions that can be asked, and we should be prepared on them. So this was all in today's editorial analysis. We'll see you next time with another editorial. Thank you.